Hi everyone, welcome to Carson City Library's Computers for Beginners video tutorial on email. My name is Vanna Bells and I am the Creative Learning Librarian where we offer programs for all ages. I've adapted this in-person class for you to learn at your own pace. This is an abbreviated version of the email class that I teach in the library. I do have an intermediate email video that I can link in the description below. The video is called Carson City Library Virtual Programs Google Apps because today we will be going over Gmail. I'll also provide a list of additional resources at the end to enhance your learning. I appreciate and welcome all feedback, so please fill out the survey in the description. Questions, you can email me at creativelearning@carsoncitylibrary.org. Let's get started. All the things I'm teaching you today can be applied to other email providers, such as Yahoo, Hotmail, Outlook. All these email service providers have the same functions. What makes them different is how they present your emails to you, how you're able to organize them, etc. All these images that I'm showing you are from the Google website itself, which I will share with you at the end of the video. More tips and tricks on how to use Gmail. When you click compose, that's when you are writing a new email to somebody. The to field is where you would type in the email address. The subject is where you would type in the subject of the email. Ignore this, that's unfortunate, but this says choose text alignment. So this row here is for you to format your email. So if you wanted to change the text size to make it smaller or larger, or change the font style, this is the bar you would do that. The bar at the bottom, this is the send button. This button removes this formatting bar. If you're not going to format your message, this hides this formatting bar. These are where you add attachments, links, emojis, files, or images. This paperclip is a universal symbol for adding attachments. So if you see a paperclip, you know that's what you press when you want to send a file to someone. An example of a file is a Word document, a PDF, or even a picture. What's different about this button versus this button is that this is to insert a picture directly into the message. When you send someone an image in the message, you're not giving them the file for them to save onto the computer. You're just showing them the picture in your email message. These buttons here are for intermediate users, and I do reference this in my other video. These three dots, this is one of the universal symbols for more options. So you can click here and then there are more options. And then this is to delete your draft. This is a draft because you haven't sent this email to anyone yet. If you don't want to send this email to someone, you can delete it. Here is the example of what an email looks like before you write anything. That graphic that I showed you earlier is outdated because they have added even more features that you can do. Again, these are advanced or intermediate options. For instance, this one is sending money to someone. I've never even used that feature before. But anyway, I am going to write an email to my team. So this is the email that you can reach me at so I can answer all your questions. creativelearning@carsoncitylibrary.org. And my subject is hi. And I'm just going to write hello. So again, this is the formatting. I can highlight the text and make this bold, italicized. I can even change the color if I wanted to. It's not necessary. I can click on that button to hide the formatting bar, and then I can send this email to someone. One of the new features of Gmail is this more send options. Basically, if I'm working on an email at 2 a.m. and I don't want the recipient to know that I'm sending it out at 2 a.m, I can schedule this email to go out at a different time. And now I'm going to delete this because I don't actually want to send this to my team. Now I wanted to show you the inbox. This is what you would see if you just opened a Gmail account and you haven't received anything. This is the inbox. Gmail offers one inbox, but tabs within the inbox. Now I would like to explain what each of those tabs mean. The first tab is primary. This is email from people you know and any other messages that don't appear in other tabs. Social are messages from social networks, media sharing sites, and other social websites. For instance, if you use Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you might be getting emails from them daily, weekly, whatever you choose, and then they would show up in your social tab. Promotions, these are deals, offers, and other promotional email. For example, if you subscribe to Bed Bath & Beyond and you get their 20% off coupons, it would show up in the promotions tab. Updates are notifications such as confirmations, receipts, bills, and statements. So if you pay for your, if you live in Carson City and you pay for water, the city provides your bill via email, so you would get it in your updates tab. Last but not least, forums are messages from online groups, discussion boards, and mailing lists. So if you subscribe to a blog, it would show up in the forums tab. You don't have to use these tabs. You can go to your inbox settings and uncheck these. Uncheck these if you don't want these tabs to show up. I'm going to now send an email to myself so you can see what an email in your inbox looks like. So this is the library's practice email for computer classes. So it knew who I was, and you can always email yourself. Anytime you want to send yourself a file and you want to have it in your inbox for safekeeping, this is how you would do it. Write your own email address, subject test. The subject is test, and I'm just going to send it. So here it is. Super quick, shows up. When you receive an email, you can star it, which means you can favorite it so you know not to delete it. These are for intermediate email users. But anything you see that you don't know, you can always move your mouse over the icon and a window will pop up explaining what that means. So everything on the internet and on the computer, a lot of them just show you icons. They don't show you the word with the icon, or they don't show you the word at all, just the icon. That's just for visual aesthetics. If you had too many words on the screen, it would be very cluttered. So that's why they use icons. But anytime you don't know what it is, you can hover over and it should tell you what it is. So this symbol here is another way to organize your emails. I don't use this feature. I'm happy with just the star. So if I star this, click on this, and then unclick. You can see here it tells me conversation marked as not important, and I can always undo. So I'm going to click on this email. and I've read the email and I can respond to this or I can forward this email. These are more options. This is another, this button is the same as this one button. You can see that symbol is the same as this symbol. And if I wanted to know more details, it tells me the time. And if I needed to see, say this was another person who sent me this email, I can click on that arrow to see the full email address. I'm back in my inbox and I want to do something with this email. I'm not going to respond to it. I can delete it. If I click on this box, more icons show up and like I said, if I hover over it, it tells me what those icons mean. So I can either save this in my email, but not assign it a label. So that's what archiving means. I'm not organizing it into a specific place, but I'm not deleting it either. If this was a spam email, I would click this. So say you received junk email or spam email that you didn't sign up for, you can click on that. And Gmail uses its algorithm to figure out what should be sent to you and what should not be sent to you. It's not going to delete anything. It's just going to be sent to your spam folder, which is here. I can delete it. I can mark it as unread. I can snooze, add to tasks, move to. This is where I would move it to another folder, or I can add a label to this and I can click on more options. There are many things you can do with Gmail. Everything also shows up in two places. So this row shows up here, but if I hover over here, more icons show up. But you just need to remember that those icons are not going to show up until you select something, because it wants to know what you want to do with this specific email. I am going to delete this, and now I have no new email. And on the left-hand side are all of these folders and labels. You can make your own folder or label. All of these were generated by Gmail. So I can go to the bottom and create my own label. You can also color coordinate. I did make this one. I made a family label. And if you click on this more, I can change the label color. Because of the current situation, Gmail has updated their video conferencing tool. So it's called Google Meet. You can start a video call with anybody via email, and you can use these buttons here. This is brand new. I might offer a class on this, its own class on this, but I just want to let you know this is new, and that's why this is here, because of the current situation. And you can also chat with other people if they use Gmail. So this is video chat, and then this is just text chat. That was a very brief introduction to email. I do have a second video for intermediate users about Gmail. I have to admit that video is not my best. That is when I just first started creating videos for the library, but I've gotten a lot better with practice. So this is the additional resource that I wanted to share with you. This is Gmail training and help from Google itself. They have lots of great cheat sheets and tips. I will provide the link in the video description. As always, I would love feedback. I also want to know what kind of content you want to see. Please fill out the survey in the video description. And again, if you have any questions, please email me at creativelearning@carsoncitylibrary.org. Thank you so much. Stay strong, Carson City. Bye.